In this video, we will be reviewing Unit 5, which includes complex conditionals and more key events. First, we have compound conditionals, which is a powerful tool that allows us to test for multiple conditions in if or elif statements. This can be done by using words such as and, or, and not. So let's take a look at what all of these mean. So if we decide to use and, we can connect two different conditions and test for both of them to be true. So if we want mouse X to be greater than 200 and mouse Y to be less than 100, this would be true only when both cases are true. Or on the other hand, works only if at least one case is true. So if one of these is true or both of these are true, this entire statement will be true. And finally, not is for cases that are false rather than true. So if not mouse X less than 200. So this entire statement will only be entered only when a mouse X is not less than 200. So by having compound conditionals, we will be able to test for more conditions with one if or elif statement. Another way to test for multiple conditions is using nested conditionals, in which you put more conditionals within other conditionals. And these can actually be equivalent to compound conditionals. So let's take a look at this example down here. So we have this mouse press defined, and there's two main cases when X is greater than 200 and when X is not greater than 200. So here's this line. This is the greater than 200 region. This is the less than 200 region. But on top of that, we also are testing that within the X is greater than 200 region, is Y greater than 200? If so, draw a light green circle, and here it is. And if it's not, draw an orange circle, and here that is. But this can actually be completely converted into compound conditionals. So instead of having two if statements, one inside the other, you can just have one and connect the two conditions with and. So it could be written as, if X is greater than 200 and Y is greater than 200, draw a light green circle with the label yes. Another built-in function that we can use is OnKeyhold, which can get called when a key is pressed and then held. To call it, we use the function OnKeyholdKeys. To test if a specific key is clicked, we have to test if it is in keys, since OnKeyhold can actually respond to multiple keys being held down simultaneously. The keys parameter is actually any key that has been pressed currently. So this actually allows for continuous and natural motion because we can say attach the movement of a dot to an arrow key and make it look like it's continuously moving in one direction when that key is held. Thanks for tuning in. I hope this helped with your review of Unit 5. Make sure to check out the notes and all of the review material we have online on the CS Academy website.